Hello everyone and welcome back to another episode of Dark Souls 2 PvP. Today I'm again dueling with my painting guardian cosplay build, and now I have the painting guardian leggings and dual wield monastery scimitars, which leads to more problem than it solves, because now people constantly think I'm scrubby and monastery parry, but I use my rapier and my normal scimitar to parry, like here, rapier parry, no, monastery parry. You saw that? I'm not scum. Please, please. And I need monasteries for a good cosplay, okay? Man. Alright, this guy, like I said in the last Painting Guardian episode, he is playing with the buffed up curved dragon greatsword, which is OP and has a 2-hit. That weapon, that damage, man, it's bullshit. But I'm still wrecking his face. I think I'm doing that because he's kind of bad in playing this game, which you already can tell from his setup. Spin to win. 4-hit spin to win combo of the Painting Guardian sword. By the way, who of you guys who watching this and played Dark Souls 1 reminds of the Painting Guardian sword? Was it their moveset? It had constantly spinning attacks and looked so fancy, and now it has only 2 spin attacks. The rest are normal curved sword move class attacks, which is kind of bad that they did that and did the scrubby parry frames that they patched out and patched in again. And From did a pretty damn bad job at the monastery, if you ask me and all other skilled people. Of course, unskilled people or unhonorable playing people want to use that and want it as scrubby, and it is good for gangbangs, but come on, monastery, come on. And this guy constantly casting too. Wrath of the Gods, and I think, like, oh, come on. Seriously now, I want to parry you. I will parry you, come on, attack me. Oh, not like that attacking me, okay. Please, boy, please. Saw and parry. Oh, man. And Shadow Dagger, because, yeah, the Shadow Dagger, I had it in the main hand from gangspanking. Fast fight was this. OP 4-hit stun lock. And yeah. This guy. Yeah, in a bad situation. He did a quite good job out of that. But yeah, what should I do? Standing there and blocking. Should I not attack him? Also, you see this? I am a white painting guardian with a blue aura, which looks just amazing. It's amazing. I'm fabulous, bitch. Yeah. I'm rank 2 in the Sentinels of Blue and in waiting as a blue. And so I have the white ring, so I am like that. And it looks fabulous, like I said. Also, ranking up in the Blue Covenant is fair in contrast to the rank up in the Red Covenant, but because if you rank up in the Red Covenant, not Red Covenant, but Brotherhood of Blood, so the Red Color Covenant, it's bad because you have to play scummy. Just have to have a cheap setup that you always win in the arena. But now that I think about it, sorry for Shadow Dagger repost. Now that I think about it, it is actually good of FromSoft to do this scummy Red Covenant level up. Because, if you think about it, the Brotherhood of Blood is a covenant where it is about they are bad, and they are bad people, and they are... you have to fear them. So, if you play this Forbidden Sun spam... Yeah, it did hit me, but what the fuck, the spam? Where was I? My brain. If you rank up in the Red Covenant, you have to be a scummy player. And so, they are sorting out the honorable players, which are then mostly in the Blue Covenant, or mostly in the Blue Covenant and in No Covenant, to the bad players and scummy players who are in the Red Covenant. And so it makes sense that they do the Red Covenant scummy, so that they only have bad playing people in the Red Covenant, so that they are feared and seemed and viewed as bad players. So good job at FromSoft, but it's unfortunate for the PvP itself, because I never were and will never be rank 3 in the Brotherhood of Blood Covenant, because I never play, or I try to not play, as scummy as all people there, or most people there. If you go to the arena, you will see what I mean. Also, there are, yeah, I don't have to say more. With the Red Covenant, you all know it, how it is in the arena. Bad players, but OP players, and OP players mostly wreck, not OP players. Unfortunately, it is like that. So, overall, the Painting Guardian PvP dueling was very much fun. It was amazing to play as a Painting Guardian. You look fabulous, you play fabulous, and everything's fine. And in the end, I even had a few good duels. And I met Mircea randomly, and so Leakful Doors. If you watch this dueling episode, I played with this setup. It's amazing. It's amazing. In the end, I love Dark Souls 2 PvP like I love Dark Souls 1 PvP. It has its mistakes, but if you go back to Dark Souls 1, Dark Magic was a big unbalanced thing, like there are big unbalanced things in Dark Souls 2. So don't complain, try to love it as it is, and maybe we will never have a PvP as good as and as entertaining as the Dark Souls 2 PvP. So this guy, katana, and backstabbing. Here I'm again back at my setup that I have in the that I had in the first video with Hide Knight's leggings, which are kind of fortunate for that build because you have a bit of poise. But also it's not that important because poise doesn't mean anything in this game. Here, this is a small duel against Mistborn, who helped me transferring my second Monastery Scimitar from my other character to this, and he said like, oh god, full scumbag mode, and I said like, no, duel me now. And this is the duel, he with dual whips and I with dual monastery. Yeah, of course I couldn't parry him and I wouldn't have parried him, but Monastery Scimitar is an awesome weapon. And so, I kinda get his face slapped. Also, he's playing with a poison setup, which requires people to be constantly near you to poison me, to get to poison enemies. This is also a Mistborn, but he didn't poison me, so he didn't get good damage in, which requires poisoning with this build. Here he has a Murakumo, which I love the blue Murakumo. Here, left-right comboing. Yeah. Quite not much to say anymore. Except of I'd didn't want to wreck him here, because this was sparing. This is the last guy blocking, and I think blocking and guard breaking him. Thank God we have guard breaking, so people can't turtle. Now he's low on health, but does a pretty good job to almost poisoning me, so I have to watch out quite well. And here, short reach of the Painting Guardian Sword, which is called Monastery Scimitar in this game. And oh, it's getting close. Who is winning? I think I have to pull out my BAM! Throwing knives for the win. So, thank you for watching all. I hope you enjoyed this episode. And rate, subscribe, like, comment, whatever you want. And I see you all in the next one. Bye bye.